What's going on, folks? Today we're gonna do a little bit different video from a question that I get asked very often. In fact, what I did is I took a lot of the questions and concerns and, you know, subjects that I get broached upon either on Facebook, on Instagram, or on YouTube, or on my, you know, direct messaging or emails. I put together a series for you guys called FragFacts. Now, this is not gonna be for the connoisseur or the fragrance collector, someone who's been doing this for a long time, but this is for those people that send me those messages and questions very often. So here you go, this is FragFacts part one, and we're gonna talk about how to choose a fragrance that best suits you. Let's do it. Welcome back to another video. This is going to be FragFacts part one, how to choose the best fragrance for you. And we're gonna start off by going through a couple key points that you might wanna consider before actually choosing your fragrance. The first key point to consider is body chemistry. No two people have the same body chemistry. So one thing I do tell people all the time, don't go by the test strip, you know, the bladder. Don't go by how other people smell. Do take that fragrance with you, whether it's a tester, whether it's a, decant, but wear the fragrance on your skin so you can really figure out if that particular fragrance will synergize well with your body chemistry. Second key point is going to be your personality and your style. You know, if you're a loud person, an extrovert, if you're an introvert, depending on how people see you, depending on how you, you know, present yourself in different situations, whether it's work, you know, a scent for work, if you might be looking for, you know, a perfect signature scent for your work. Maybe you're looking for something to go out, you know, to party, to try to, you know, to date, romantic settings. Every single scent is going to give you a different vibe about yourself. So your personality and the style is going to be key on how you want to smell, which goes hand to hand with the third key point here, which is going to be your occasion / setting. If you're looking for a wedding scent, if you're looking for, like I said, a work scent or, you know, a night out scent, a romantic scent, I think all those things in consideration with your body chemistry, the occasion, and your personality are the key factors when you're choosing a scent for you that better suits what you want to accomplish. Quick side note for the occasion and setting, you know, third key point here. For instance, if you're looking for an office scent, you don't want something that's gonna project or be too deep or dark or too strong. You want something that's gonna be a little bit more tame, more subtle, more crisp, more clean, more refreshing. But if you want something perhaps for a night out, maybe you want something a little heavy, a little darker, a little bit with more personality, a scent that's really going to scream and grab people's attention. So just a little food for thought here on this occasion / style. Although it might seem a little bit of a complicated and, you know, arduous process, especially if you're getting started into the fragrance world, you know, I know it could be very daunting with all these channels, all these different fragrances, you know, niche, indie, designer, it can be a little complicated. But a few other key points and factors to take into consideration is going to be the price range that you want to be at, because believe me, you don't have to spend an arm and a leg to smell amazing. There are great fragrances within every price range and every, you know, classification or genre. So keep that in mind. And of course, the concentration of your fragrance. Whether you want an eau de cologne, an eau de toilette, an eau de parfum, or an extract de parfum or pure parfum. What this means is essentially the concentration. The heavier the concentration, the more compound, the more perfume or concentrated compound the fragrance will have. First concentration here, which is, all the concentrations is pretty much a rule of thumb here, you know, a parameter in which to go by. These are not set in stone. Every concentration, depending on the brand, might change a little bit, but, you know, the main characteristics are going to be the following. For an eau de cologne, it's going to be between 3 to 6% concentration, and it's going to last between 2 to 3 hours. The next concentration up is going to be the eau de toilette. Now, the eau de toilette is going to have between 4 to 8% concentration compound, and will last between 4 to 5 hours. Next concentration up is eau de parfum, and I want to clarify a misconception that a lot of people make. Eau de parfum will be between 12 and 18%, upwards of 18% in concentration, which in theory it would last 6+ hours, but it will not project as strong as an eau de toilette. In my personal experience, 25+ years collecting fragrances, I have a lot of eau de toilettes that actually 95% of them project a lot more and stronger. They push a lot stronger from the skin than the eau de parfums. However, the eau de parfums will last longer, meaning they'll give you a nice sillage and scent bubble, but it'll stay closer to the skin. But you'll get 6 to 8 hours with eau de parfums for sure. But again, don't think that because it's higher concentration, it's gonna automatically last longer or project stronger. That's, I want to just let you guys know about that, because a lot of people make that confusion. The last concentration is pure parfum or extract de parfum, which normally is 18-20% plus, upwards of 30% in high oil concentration. And in theory, that would last the whole day on your skin or on your clothes, which, although, you know, which is really high concentrated pure parfum, would not recommend spraying your clothes because it might stain. A lot of those have a lot of pure, you know, compounds and elements which really stain. Great example of those are, you know, Rajadav, Pak Bafam extract. They have these really pure elements and compounds of like rose and amber. And when you do spray those on your clothes, you're gonna get a dark stain. Don't really spray your clothes with those pure parfums because they might stain your clothes. But they are the highest concentration, and in theory, they should last the whole day on your skin, or 12, 14 hours plus. A lot of times people make a mistake or an educated decision by buying a fragrance based on the first impression. That's how SAs, you know, sales associates, get you on the store. If you're not really well seasoned, if you don't have a well seasoned nose, if you don't know about, you know, the transition of fragrances, which we'll talk about in a second, they will spray that test strip and give you guys the smell, and you're gonna get stuck on that first impression, the introduction, which will make you fall in love 90% of the time with that fragrance, and you'll make that purchase. Then you get home, you wear it for, you know, a couple days, and you're like, wow, it doesn't smell as good as I thought this fragrance would smell. So just to clarify, don't ever go by the test strip. Actually get a decant, or if you can't get a decant, if you're in a store and you like that introduction, go ahead and spray your wrists, you know, the back of your wrists right here, and keep that scent, you know, keep going back for it for the next 30, 40 minutes, so you can actually get the whole transition of the fragrance. You know, the top notes, the heart, the mid, and the base of the fragrance, which is really what you're going to be left off with. The base of the fragrance usually heavier compounds, which will rise to the fragrance after that more ethereal top notes go away. The mid of the fragrance, or the heart, is mainly for support. And really what you're gonna be left off with are the woods, the vetivers, you know, that those darker, more resinous base notes that you have in the fragrance. So that is why it's important that you wear that fragrance on your skin for the next 30, 40 minutes, so you really smell that transition and really see how that fragrance will actually synergize with your body chemistry. In general, there is a quote unquote fragrance pyramid, but what that is, what that really summarizes, is the transition of a fragrance. Normally, the top notes at the top of the pyramid are going to be more ethereal notes, citrus notes, which will evaporate within the next 10, 15 minutes or so of the fragrance. The heart or the mid will offer support, and mostly the most of the transition of the fragrance will happen within 35, 40 minutes when the mid of the heart of the fragrance kicks in. That will last for about 35, 40 minutes, and then you left off with the base, which are the heavier, more resinous notes, which will last the remainder of the life of the fragrance. However, some fragrances are linear, which is sometimes a good thing, because if you like the introduction, you're going to have that fragrance, you know, that particular introduction for the whole life of the fragrance. Of course, stronger, lighter, and a lot lighter as the time progresses. But it's a conversation for a different video. So do pay attention to that transition of the top, the heart, and the base of the scent, because that will tell you exactly if you love the fragrance from beginning to end. The idea here is to find a fragrance that has a base that you love, so that, you know, the top or the mid, you don't really mind, but you actually like. But really the base, the dry down, is what you're really gonna fall in love with, because again, that's what you're gonna be left off with. Your body chemistry, going back to that, is a very important factor, because if you do like the scent and actually agrees with the body chemistry that your body produces, you have a winner. If you have a fragrance that you keep going back to it and just agrees with you and you can't stop smelling yourself or your wrists where you're testing the fragrance, it means you actually found the fragrance that perfectly suits you. And that's why when people ask me, fragrance is very subjective. It's something that's, you know, taste is very subjective. Of course, it's involving your, you know, sense of smell, how you smell things, and of course, your body chemistry. A fragrance that you smell on someone that might smell amazing on them might smell horrible on you, or vice versa. Once you have gotten to the point that you can't stop smelling yourself and you think you found your perfect signature scent, I actually suggest and recommend one more step. Actually try to get a sample from the SA of the store that you're smelling the fragrance at, or check your favorite decant shop to procure or purchase a decant so you can live with it for a few days, maybe a week's time. I'd say 3 to 5 days is the optimal here, because that way you really feel the fragrance, you know, from beginning to end, different settings. That way you'll be able to figure out where does the fragrance fits the best according to your personality. So that's all I have for you guys today on FragFacts Part 1. Stay tuned for Part 2 coming very soon. And of course, if you have any further questions of other things you guys would like me to talk about when it comes to fragrance facts, please drop it in the comment section. I'll be sure to check it out and come back with that particular FragFact video for you. In the meantime, thanks so much for your support. Please don't forget to hit the like button. I would really appreciate it if you guys subscribe and hit the notification bell icon so you get future videos straight into your feed, just like this one. As always, remember, fragrance is emotion, so wear what truly moves you. I'll see you again real soon.